In Norway, there is a major disaster which is one day almost certain to occur, causing what will be the equivalent in today's money of as much as $2 billion. In a worst-case scenario, this very disaster will result in the creation of an up to 100-meter or 328-foot-high megatsunami going on to strike a populated fjord, potentially destroying thousands of structures where more than 15,000 people live, along with numerous boats and several ports. While the most likely outcome of this future disaster will be a much smaller tsunami, as what was just described was a worst-case scenario, even a smaller event would be still quite destructive and have the potential to cause casualties. The disaster I am referring to can be found on a steep mountainside 23 kilometers west-southwest of the town of Tafjord. There, for several generations, locals had noticed a small crack on this very hillside, which they simply referred to as the crack. In the 1960s, this crack was several hundred meters long, but only a few centimeters wide. Yet, ever since then, it has continued to widen and lengthen, with it now reaching 820 meters in length and several meters wide. This crack is merely the surface exposure caused by a large volume and slow-moving landslide moving at an average rate of 1 to 2 centimeters a year towards the bottom of the fjord. In total, an area of approximately 0.38 square kilometers encompassing 60 million cubic meters of rock are involved in this landslide referred to as the Åknes landslide, which has already moved more than a meter since it was first detected. Since scientists have witnessed highly similar slow-moving landslides elsewhere on the planet, they are rather certain that this slope will eventually fail, crashing down into the fjord below and generating a tsunami. But as to whether this occurs via repeated increments of only a few million cubic meters or the entire mass of rock all at once is unclear. It is also unclear when this future disaster will occur, as technically speaking it could occur this year, next year, sometime this century, or several thousand years from now. One source states that the yearly chance of a collapse is about 1 in 1,000, however, this is merely an estimate. We do not know when this collapse will occur, but assume that the landslide will greatly pick up in speed before it suddenly fails. Luckily, the relevant hillside is one of the most monitored slopes in all of Europe, with dozens of sensors always watching and monitoring this mountainside. Here is a brief outline of a hypothetical worst-case collapse scenario, although it assumes that everyone would get proper warning and successfully evacuate beforehand. After a winter of unusually heavy snowfall, the season turns to spring and the temperature rises. This causes ice and snow in the ground to thaw and melt, leaving voids where they once were. This suddenly causes the slope to unexpectedly begin moving at a speed of 30 centimeters a day, causing the evacuation of all nearby towns and making it forbidden to be close to the maximum run-up heights expected in various locations. A few days to weeks later, the entire edifice fails and crashes into the fjord below, initially generating a 100-meter or 328-foot-high megatsunami. Due to the fact that this landslide initially moved in a southeast direction, the highest tsunami run-up heights would occur to the south. As the tsunami crashes against the shoreline, all trees would be removed where it struck, leaving behind a brown or gray layer of sediment. 3.5 minutes later, an 85-meter or 279-foot-high wave would strike Helseelet, sweeping away the majority of the settlement. An additional 3 minutes later, the still towering wave would strike Geringer, destroying the western half of the town. As the northern lobe of the tsunami moved northward, it created wave heights of between 6 and 16 meters in the adjacent lobe of the fjord. 12 minutes after the tsunami began, the wave would strike Vale, by which time it had reduced to only 7 meters in height. Anything hit after 22 minutes had passed could still sustain extreme damage, with wave heights maxing out at 5 meters in height. After 30 minutes total had elapsed, the wave would continue outwards, but by then would only be less than 1 meter in height. The reason this landslide is occurring is due to the fact that this hillside used to contain a layer of permafrost which held what would otherwise be an unstable slope in place. Yet, as temperatures notably warmed in the last few centuries, the extent of permafrost greatly decreased until it disappeared altogether on the relevant hillside. Melting water from snowfall was then able to seep into areas the permafrost used to be in, and this created repeating cycles of freeze-thaw which caused the cracks to continue to widen. This widening occurred because when water turns into ice, it expands by about 9% volume. As a final note, I would like to thank this channel's new patron, Mark Evers, for supporting this channel.